One of the great things about MindTap is that because of the unique learning path, it's already set up to be used as is. So if you're not super comfortable with technology, you really don't have to do a thing. But if you're like me, you may not want to use all of the content that's in a chapter, or you may not want to cover it in the exact order that's already there. So the good news is that the learning path is customizable, and you don't have to be super tech savvy in order to make some changes and to personalize your course. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to hide, unhide, move, and reorder items in the learning path. So in front of you, you do see a learning path for the book, Becoming a Master Student. And as I mentioned before, I don't cover all of the chapters in a book, mostly because my course is a one-credit hour course. So 12 chapters is obviously way too much. Plus, the learning outcomes for my course don't match up to some of the chapters anyway. So I'm going to skip, chapters 10, 11, and 12. So I want to hide these from the students. This way they're not confused. They don't think that they have to cover these chapters. So I want to show you how easy it is to do that. All you need to do is take your mouse and hover over the chapter. Move over to the right, and you'll see a pencil, and you'll see a circle with a slash through it. That circle with a slash through it is the hide button. So it's very easy. All I have to do to hide chapter 10, for example, is to click on that circle. When I go back down, you will see that it's grayed out. All I have to do are the same steps for chapter 11 and 12, is click on the circle, and click on the circle for 12, and they're hidden. Now, you may want to hide content and then reopen it later in the semester. In other words, you may want to even release chapters as you go. This way the students don't get ahead, work ahead, and not follow the plan that you have. Let's say I wanted to reopen chapter 12, the next steps, because I decide that this is a great chapter for the students to think about what they want to do in the future, next semester, etc., etc. So I hover over chapter 12 again, and notice how where that circle with the slash was, now there's an eyeball. And that eyeball allows you to unhide or show the material or that item again. So all I have to do is click the eye, and I go back down, and voila, chapter 12 is back. So I also mentioned that I don't always cover material in the same order that the textbook has it. So let's say I wanted to move this chapter 3 on memory so it's closer down to chapter 7, thinking. Let me show you how easy it is to do that. Next to that circle, next to the hide button, is a little pencil, and that's the edit button. When I click on the edit button, it opens up a screen that allows me to do a few things. But the thing that we're going to show you right now is how to actually change the order of where that item goes. So instead of it being before chapter 5, I want it to be before chapter 7. So from the drop-down menu, I will choose before chapter 7, and I can click save there, and we'd be done. But I also want to show you a couple of other things. One, we'll go a little more in depth later, but you can also add a start date, or you can add an end date. So this also allows you to open the item and close the item on certain dates. So I've already chosen where I want the order. I click save, and notice that when we come back to the learning path, chapter 3 on memory is now down by chapter 7, thinking where I want it to be. Now let me show you how to move an item. So we see this CSF5 for Becoming a Master Student. Let's say I wanted to move this away from the main learning path and put it into one of the units, specifically the introduction, since it's a pre-test, if you will. So I can click on the edit button, and instead of choosing a drop-down menu from order, I want to choose it from add to location. So I want to move the CSFI test to introduction the master student. So I choose that from the drop-down menu. I click save. And you notice how it's gone from the main learning path But when I click on the introduction, notice how now the CSFI is within the chapter. So within a chapter, I can also hide, unhide, move, and reorder items. So let's say out of these 6 or 7 items, I only want to have the students complete 3 or 4 of them. I definitely want them to watch the video on the learning outcomes, and I want them to skip the engagement activities. So the same thing as the main learning path. You hover over the item, you click the hide button, and that item is hidden. And let's say for at least for right now, I want to hide the reflection activity. So I click on the hide button, and voila, that activity is hidden. So notice how even within the path, I can hide, within the chapter, I can hide items as well. So now that we've looked at hiding, unhiding, moving, and reordering, we're going to look at renaming units and items in the next video.